What's up, ladies and gentlemen? I didn't click the record button. Fuck. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Theory in the Daw. My name is Gardner. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Theory in the Daw. My name is Garden Sound, and this, of course, is Lila the bird, who's been a very good bird and gets an almond. We are back today talking about keys and scales. And if you haven't seen my video on tonality, I highly, 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 highly recommend that you go check that out. Link in the description below and at the end of this video. As always, this is a companion series for my course that is for sale on Live Producers Online. Go check them out. Links in the description down below. Today, we're gonna be talking about keys and scales. I'm not talking about car keys. I'm talking about the grouping of notes that determines what a it's like an assembly, like a set, like the default pitches. Think of it this way. It's basically a musical preset. It's the code for what the majority of pitches are gonna be in a song. Let's go to Wikipedia for the actual definition. In music theory, the key of a piece is the group of pitches or scale that forms the basis of a musical composition in classical, Western art, and Western pop music. Let's stop right there. In musical theory, the key of a piece is the group of pitches or scale that forms the basis of musical composition, meaning it is the foundation of what are the pitches that could possibly occur in the song, and that's it. That's it. That's all a key is. And so people are like constantly trying to fight with each other about what the key of this is, what the key of that is. Really, it is only for informational purposes, and it doesn't usually determine much other than what the notes are. And I think people get lost there. That's the jumping off point for a lot of arguments. It doesn't really matter what key something is in unless you're playing it, in which case knowing the key would help you pick it up quicker. But again, if you've seen my video on tonality, you know that we've gone over before how to find the tonic, how to find the central pitch of something. That's oftentimes going to be the first degree or the first note of the key. I think we did an example where I did like F or something, like the tonic was F. The fundamental pitch of a song was F. You could safely assume that the name of the key is going to be F something. And the thing that determines what the something is, perfect segue, is the scale. So the scale, let's go over this now. In music theory, a scale is any set of musical notes ordered by fundamental frequency or pitch. Boom! Your boy nailed it. So you take the fundamental and the distances between notes from there, the number of notes from there until we get back around to the next note, the next fundamental, the number of notes plus the distances that they're spaced apart determines the scale. Think about it this way. The key is the set of notes, the set of preset notes in that specific song. The scale is how they're divided up, is how that particular group of notes is broken up and in what order they should be played, or could be played, really. I don't like to use the word should when I teach theory, because theory is more of a guideline and less of a rule, unless you're writing 18th century counterpoint and you're Bach, in which case they are the rules. But we're not Bach, and this is not the 18th century, this is 2018, and we're talking about classical theory and applying it to modern music. The scale of music, right? How are these notes? How is this key broken up? What are other names, other qualifiers we can add on to the fundamental pitch in our example, which was F, right? F what? F major, F minor, F Dorian, F Mixolydian. What do these words mean? The qualifier or the scale, right? The thing attached to the fundamental, that tells me how the notes are spaced apart and how they're broken up. And there really isn't a good way to remember how it works other than to simply memorize it. I hate to say it, just gotta kind of memorize it. But they're all based on the chromatic scale, okay? All of these different scales are based on the chromatic scale. And if we're going over into Ableton for just a second, let me show you what I'm talking about. All right, so here's the chromatic scale. This is what it sounds like. It's just a half step at every space. What can you do with the chromatic scale? Not much. Just kidding. If you're Missy Elliott, what you can do is break it up at the halfway point and extend it by a tritone in parallel, and you get this. And if you're Missy Elliott, you're not gonna just write that out yourself. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take it from the song Cybotron, Clear.
Face
chubby waist, thick legs in shape. And now you know. There are a lot of cool things you can do with the chromatic scale, going back to Ableton. You can break it up, and that's where we get our other scales. So let's take this chromatic scale. All right, we're gonna paste it down here. And what we're gonna do is we're going to just see if we can break this up a different way. So first I'm gonna take it and drop it down an octave. Too far. Cool. Now let's just start eliminating some notes. Oh my God, we just made a major scale. So what the chromatic scale is it's the basis for the rest of the scales. Everything is related to the chromatic scale somehow, okay? And all we've done to make a major scale is just chop out some of the notes. The major scale is part of a series of heptatonic scales, meaning there are seven pitches, hepta, that make up the tonic or tonality of the scale. There are tons of heptatonic scales. In fact, the majority of music in Western society is heptatonic. Check this out, I'm gonna make it minor. So to make it minor, and this again is just memorization, which you can do if you check out musictheory.net, it's a great place to study your scales. We're gonna make this minor. Here's how it works. First off, we have to take the third, and we have to drop it down a half step. Again, we're staying right in the chromatic scale. The entirety of Western music theory based on chromatic scales. You can even see it in the piano roll. Everything's based into a half step. Isn't that great? We're gonna drop the third down a half step. We're gonna go ahead and drop the seventh down a half step. And then we're gonna drop the sixth down a half step. And here it sounds. That would be harmonic minor right there by raising the seventh. Just a heptatonic scale. To make it melodic minor, raise the sixth and the seventh. Now, there are a whole bunch of heptatonic scales, and these are all called modes. I don't know why they call them modes, honestly, but they're called modes. And another way to say that would just to be alternate scales, other than major and minor, which are two of the modes. You already know two of them. There's seven of them. The Aeolian mode, right, is the fancy word for it, but we call it minor. And the Ionian mode, that's a fancy word for major. And now you know, Ionian and Aeolian. The other modes of the heptatonic scale include Ionian, which is major, Dorian. I've already messed this up. Oh yeah, sorry. Ionian, Dorian, Phrygian, Lydian, Mixolydian, Aeolian, Locrian. Those are the seven modes of the heptatonic scale, and I'm going to include some reading about those in the description down below. A lot of melodic metal music is going to bounce back and forth between Phrygian, Mixolydian, and Lydian. So go check that out. If you're learning like metal music, you probably are very familiar with the Mixolydian scale. That's all that the scale is. It's just kind of an order, a way to break up those 12 pitches. Spent the majority of our time here talking about heptatonic scales, which are just seven note scales, but there are also pentatonic scales, which is five notes, very common in Asian music. And there is also hexatonic scales, which are a bit different. They only use six notes. And there's also octatonic scales, which are pretty weird. But for the rest of our time today, I want to focus on a couple of musical examples that use different scales and cool things to do with them. We've already discussed Cybotron and Missy Elliott, which is a great use of the chromatic scale. Let's go over to Tool's song, The Pot. The cradle and burn the evidence down. Soapbox house of cars and glass. Oh, don't go tossing your stones around. You must have been. What I like about Tool, and I'm pausing right there for two reasons. One, copyright infringement, and two, they get a little bit vulgar with the language. We try to keep things advertiser friendly around here. What I like about Tool in this song particularly is that they tend to emphasize the tonic because they also then kind of go out on these tangents where they reference all of the notes that are uncommonly used in a scale. I believe this is Dorian. I'm not 100% sure on that. I'm sure somebody will let me know in the comments section. The bass line has this repeating figure called an ostinato, and that's basically a melodic idea that repeats and repeats and repeats. This song, Cybotron Clear, this is an ostinato. It repeats at regular intervals. That's an ostinato. Now you know. So they've got this bass line that's holding down the fort, and then they go all over the place with the guitar, with pitch bends, and really exploring the harmonic space of the scale. So this is an example of extended tonality, right? So taking things and going beyond the scale, going beyond the boundaries of that, but they still are rooting the song on the tonic, which is what's allowing them to go further with it, if that makes sense. So if you want to play with stuff, maybe keeping a firm foundation on that tonic note and then messing with it over top, that's fun stuff. Next up, we have Cherry by Ratatat. Now, this is an example of a song that has an ostinato or a basso profundo, right? Or a cyclical portion of the song at the very bottom that continues to repeat and repeat and repeat and build and build and build. And this is an example of extended tonality that's very diatonic or very of the scale. So the opposite, right? So Tool would be exploring the harmonies, and this is staying contained within the harmony and rooted within the harmony, but building in a way that makes it sound magnificent. I'm going to play the end of this. Never heard that song in its entirety, I definitely recommend that you go check it out. It's one of my favorite songs of all time. But that's a great example of staying contained within a harmonic envelope, but just really pulling all the feelings that you can out of it. And that's going to be something we talk about later, which is like note and intervallic relationship and how notes move from one note to another. But that's enough for today. I think I filled your head with enough garbage. If you'd like to follow me over to Live Producers Online, there's a link in the description below that you can sign up and check it out. I'm going to be continuing this lesson, getting more into specifics on Ableton. But as always, my name's Gardner, this is Lila the Bird, and we'll see you next time.